Hi there. In my recent videos, I've been showcasing the results of my work on Alice, my AI assistant. Currently, I'm developing her API, which allows her to perform slightly more complex tasks. I thought it would be a great idea to share my experiences in a video series here on YouTube. In this episode, we'll focus on one of the key elements of interacting with an assistant, which is intent recognition. Alice has access to various types of information and a range of skills. However, it is important to me that she is able to make decisions on her own about what she should do at any given moment. For example, if I ask her a question about previously remembered note, I would like her to focus solely on the area of memory where she stores notes. Thanks to this, I reduce the noise while searching through their memories and increase chances of finding the desired information. For example, one of her memories in the notes category includes information about an alternative to the AI Writer app. If I now ask her about it, I will receive the expected response. However, if I ask her now to play music on Spotify, I want to do it using the same text field and let her choose on her own. Her task is to identify that I'm referring to taking action and then carry it out based on previously memorized instruction. The current mechanism works quite well, and only in isolated cases does Alice misinterpret my commands or incorrectly perform specific tasks. The effectiveness here depends on the quality of prompts I provide. The one responsible for identifying intention, I initially created on my own and then improve it with the help of ChatGPT. But before I show you how, I'd like us to take a look at the current memory schema of Alice. Alice's memory is currently divided in 6 areas, including the history of our conversation, her memories, notes, resources, creations, and skills. Each of them is managed independently, as I will demonstrate in upcoming videos, and they can be accessed separately or together. So when I say hello Alice, Alice recognizes it as a search for all of her memories because I'm not referring to any specific information, and based on that, she provides a response. But if I ask her to play music, she identifies it as a command to be executed. In this situation, her task is to search, recognize, and perform the requested action. Here in the playground, we have a defined prompt that aims to return a JSON object describing the intention for the given query. In this case, we have the identification of 2 previous queries, but from the perspective of the application's code, Alice always interprets them individually. The prompt itself contains instruction, type definitions, category descriptions, and a set of few short examples showcasing sample classifications. As I mentioned, I designed the initial version of the prompt on my own, but then I switched to ChatGPT to improve it. I started the conversation by clarifying the context and providing a detailed explanation of the task, requesting the generating of a set of clarifying questions. Then I went through several more iterations until I reached the final version of the prompt, in which I made a few minor changes. Then I transferred the prepared prompt to my application, encapsulating it with a function that is executed at the beginning of each interaction because it determines what will happen next and how Alice's behavior will change. In practice, just a single entry point is enough for Alice to flexibly respond to the ongoing flow of the conversation. What's more, the summary of the discussion is also included in the prompt, which she can utilize for classification purpose. I think that would be all for today. You can find the current version of the prompt in the description of this video. If you have any suggestions or want to ask me a question, feel free to leave a comment. In the meantime, see you in the next videos.